the first of the three arguments that the Rebbe proposes that undermine the thesis that the term Achrit HaYamim is biblical code for the Yemot HaMashiach is that this thesis would be valid if every single use of this term Achrit HaYamim would point to the Yemot HaMashiach. Thus far we have demonstrated, as noted in the footnote, that the use of Achrit HaYamim in Devarim, Yirmiyahu, and Yeshayahu point to the Messianic era. There are, however, 9 other instances throughout the Tanakh where the term Achrit HaYamim is used, and for which either there is no evidence from within the text that points to Yemot HaMashiach, or that, in fact, the text suggests that the term refers to the short long-term period. One example brought by the Rebbe in the Sicha is from Bamidbar 24:14, the prophecies of Bilam HaRasha that were made at the request of Balak, subsequent to Bilam's failure to curse the Bnei Yisrael. He tells Balak, Ve'ata hinini holech la'ami, I am going to return back to my nation. Lecha i'atzecha, come, I will advise you how to bring about the downfall of the Bnei Yisrael. And also, I shall inform you, Asher ya'aseh ha'am hazeh la'amecha, what this people, the Bnei Yisrael, will do to your nation, the Moabites, be'achrit hayamim. He then launches into a series of parable/prophecies, one of which is the famous Dorach Kochav miYaakov v'kam Shevet miYisrael. And while the Rambam identifies the Kochav as a metaphor for Mashiach, Rashi, from the standpoint of the Pshuto Shel Mikra, applies the prophecy to David HaMelech, who, with the ascendancy of Bnei Yisrael, will subjugate Amecha, the nation of Moab, ba'achrit hayamim. And while there are clear references to a messianic era within Bilam's prophecy, such as in Pasuk 19, Ve'hevid srid mi'ir, and Rashi comments, Val melech ha-mashiach omer kein, that the mi'ir referred to in the Pasuk refers to the ir ha-chashuva shel Edom, the capital of the Edomite kingdom, namely Hi-Romi, this has no bearing upon Pasuk 14, and the achrit hayamim that relates to the conquering of Moab by the armies of David HaMelech. And therefore, while we can produce evidence linking Achrit HaYamim to the Yemot HaMashiach from Devarim, Yirmiyahu, and Yeshayahu, there are also 9 other instances whereby the term Achrit HaYamim is used, and for which the context suggests that the prophecy is localized. In most instances, the Navi foretells of some punishment that was to be meted out to one of the many empires of the Middle East, be it Mitzrayim, Ashur, the Edomites, the Persians, that are specifically short, long-term in nature. On this basis, the Rebbe rejects the thesis that because the term Achrit HaYamim is used in Bereshit 49, it without question points to the Messianic era. Which brings us back to the core difficulty. What basis does the Gemara have, along with Rashi, that Bikesh Yaakov Legalot et Haketz, plan A, there was the departure of the Shekhinah, and therefore Yaakov launched him to plan B, the blessing of his 12 sons.